Do you have Simulink simulations that you would like to run faster, but don't know where to start? Then you're in the right place, as in this video series, I will show you 5 practical tips that can help you considerably speed up your simulation. The first tip that I would recommend is to check your simulation mode. For desktop simulations, you can choose between the normal, accelerator, or rapid accelerator modes. Let's open an existing model to explain what these 3 simulation modes are and illustrate how your choice of the simulation mode will affect the simulation speed. Once the model is open, you can select the simulation mode directly from the simulation tab. However, in this video, I will use the MATLAB command line to toggle between these 3 simulation modes and measure times, so that we can take a deeper look at the time cost. To start off, let's first set the simulation mode to normal and run the model. We can see that the initialization stage, including the model update, takes about 0.8 seconds, and the overall simulation execution took about 54 seconds. Let's now consider this to be the baseline, and now let's use the accelerator mode to see how it performs against the normal mode. Well, it took a little longer in the initialization phase, about 2.5 seconds. However, the simulation execution time just took 6 seconds. That's about 9 times faster than the normal mode. How can we explain this behavior? First, let's see how the simulation is generally carried out in Simulink. Simulink has an execution engine, including solvers, that invoke model methods to update the states and the output of the model at each time step. In normal mode, Simulink executes the individual blocks one by one in an interpreted fashion. This way, normal mode enables a complete feature set for the model, including debugging and diagnostics, but the performance is not necessarily optimized. However, with the accelerator mode, a just-in-time acceleration technique is used to generate code portions of the model methods in memory. Running this compiled code has less runtime overhead than the normal mode's block-by-block execution, resulting in a shorter simulation execution. But compiling this acceleration target usually takes that extra time, and that is why you see an increase in the initialization time. Fear not, for once the acceleration target is compiled and in memory, it is available for reuse. So if we run the model again in the accelerator mode, you'll see a significantly smaller initialization time. Finally, let's run the model with the final simulation mode, the rapid accelerator. We can see that it's not too bad, not as good as the accelerator mode, but still better than the normal mode. It took a total of 22 seconds, of which 20 were used for the initialization stage, and the simulation execution took about 2 seconds. So how do we explain this behavior? First, the rapid accelerator mode compiles the whole model into a rapid accelerator standalone executable, which resides outside of MATLAB and Simulink, running in its own process. It then communicates with Simulink when the model runs. So while building the executable itself takes time, the runtime overhead is much lower with the whole model compiled. Furthermore, if you don't change the model structure, recompilation is skipped when you rerun the model, thus saving you time for multiple simulations. Let's see this by running the model again. Now you see that it totally takes about 4 seconds, which is the fastest among the 3 modes. Now that we have seen how these modes work, a couple quick takeaways about a rough performance comparison between the 3 modes will be that the accelerator mode is usually faster than the normal mode, unless your simulations are short. Rapid accelerator, on the other hand, has the least per step simulation execution overhead, but the most initialization overhead. With this, there are also trade-offs you need to keep in mind. Let's conclude this video by summarizing this with the benefits of the accelerator and the rapid accelerator modes. In the accelerator mode, you have this just-in-time compiler that generates code for portions of the model. This results in a lesser time overhead when the model runs. However, this process of generating code has an overhead. Additionally, runtime diagnostics like inf and NAND checking are disabled in this mode. So a pro tip for you would be that since there is no limitation of model types that run in this mode, it's always a good check to run your model in the accelerator mode for improved simulation speeds. Now, rapid accelerator mode improves simulation speed by running as a standalone executable, which, if possible, runs on a core different from which the MATLAB process runs. However, to use the simulation mode, you need to make sure that your whole model supports code generation. Also, analogous to the accelerator mode, generating the standalone executable takes more time. So, if your simulation is short and you need to always recompile your model and henceforth the recompile of the rapid accelerator executable, then rapid accelerator may not be a good fit for you. Furthermore, debugging capabilities are disabled in this mode, except for the scopes and the viewers. If you're running long or many simulations, such as Monte Carlo simulations, then rapid accelerator can give you the best performance. Thanks for watching, and if you're interested in exploring other methods of speedup, please watch our next video in the series about the performance advisor.